one of the most important figures in history, and Nelson Mandela's legacy is alive and well, thanks in part to our next guests. His grandson, Kweku, is continuing his work, promoting a documentary on forgiveness and peace made by his friend, Lekasing. Let's make them both welcome to Studio 10.
Thank you.
Kweku, if anyone knew the art of forgiveness, it was certainly your grandfather. How did he inspire you on a personal level?
I mean, I think because he was my grandfather, ultimately, I can't really say that he did inspire me. I was inspired by people like Robert F. Kennedy and John F. Kennedy. And I'd go as far to say, you know, Gough Whitlam was someone that inspired me. I remember coming to study in Australia, and he was kind of one of the figures that stood out. And obviously, he's passed away. But what I'd say is, you know, I took a lot from what he was able to achieve in such a short amount of time. I mean, the fact that he lobbied for women to get equal pay back in that period of time is amazing, and I think it's a true reflection here. We've got four amazing women at this table. And so I'd say probably the greatest gift my grandfather ever gave me was just to be a grandfather and not be a politician.
Lekasing's documentary is about forgiveness. Mm-hmm. It seems to me your grandfather practiced forgiveness in the most extraordinary way, because I saw that prison cell that he was incarcerated in on Robben Island for 27 years, and it was appalling. It was so small in the courtyard where he sat in the sun and chipped bricks. I mean, how could you forgive anyone? The forgiveness that he showed was extraordinary.
Definitely, but I think we've seen many people throughout history. Gandhi was a great forgiver, ultimately, although, you know, he was tortured by many people. I think what's unique about Lekas' film, what's extraordinary about Lekas' film, is the fact that we're seeing these extreme situations where people really shouldn't forgive. Most people in society would think it would be fine to not forgive these people, and it's really the uniqueness of the human spirit to go above and beyond. And it took Leka years to make this film, ultimately, but what she captured is exceptional.
Shall we have a look at part of that documentary? Because you have put together the documentary of people forgiving each other in Africa, the Middle East, and Northern Ireland. Let's have a quick look at the short clip.
My sister woke me up and said, "Which hotel is Dad in? There's been a bomb in Brighton. It's on the news."
One of the dead is the MP, Sir Anthony Berry.
I was caught and sentenced to 8 life sentences, but was released after 14 years. All the things that I would admire in you came from your father. That meant this was a fine human being, and I killed him.
Leka, for all the people you've interviewed for your documentary, what sort of qualities does a forgiver have? What does it take to forgive someone?
Well, obviously, it takes an enormous amount of courage. But, you know, I started making this documentary when I met a woman whose 5 children were killed. And she was sharing a soda with the person who had killed her children. And I couldn't wrap my mind around it, and I couldn't believe that it was true.
Where was this?
This was in Rwanda. And so the film is basically my inquiry into whether that's true or not, and what it takes to see the human in another person, even if this person is killed.
And what is that, though? Because I really struggle with that. As a mum, I don't know. I couldn't do that. I couldn't forgive the person.
Yes.
How do you draw the line between forgiveness and justice? Because, of course, you have to... People do evil acts, and surely they have to also be punished for that.
The film shows the tension that exists between, you know, moving on and fighting for justice, or sometimes doing both at the same time. One is not, you know, not there for the other. I mean, forgiveness and justice both work in a strange way. But I think forgiveness is a spectrum. Mm-hmm. All of us forgive in some way or the other every single day. We just don't realize it. Whether it's somebody cutting you off at the traffic light, or you're mad with your child, or whatever it is, you know, it's a very common thing. But there's a spectrum to it, you know, it's breaking the silence. And what happens when you're compassionate is the same as what happens when you forgive. Mm-hmm. And it has reconciliation in it, it has forgiveness in it. Forgiveness is a big word, but what I wanted to show through the film is that this is possible.
Mm. All right. We've run out of time, but Kweku and Leka, thank you very much for joining us here
on
the show.
Thank you.